So, like I said in the problem, I'm going to show you a fairly naive brute force solution to this that is definitely vulnerable to some things. So, first off, we start off with the check Sudoku function from the first problem, exact same function as a base for solving the Sudoku board. After that, solve Sudoku is actually fairly short, if not exactly pretty. Import copy and sys. Here, and copy is the only one we use here. Sys is used down below for something else entirely that was for testing purposes. First, we check the grid with check Sudoku, and if check Sudoku returns none or false, we return the result. You could also assert here. I wanted to be able to continue on for testing purposes, so I just returned the result instead of asserting that, although asserting would definitely be a good idea here as well. Then we used deep copy to copy this over, and I'm not going to get into what exactly the copy package in deep copy is. Suffice to say that we made a copy of the initial input into another variable. Now, we check through the grid for zero elements, and we change them to each of 1 through 9, and then recursively call solve Sudoku on the result. So this is a very, very slow brute force process, but it's also fairly easy to code up as well. So for each element in the grid, we check if it's zero, and then for all n in the range 1 through 10, so all elements 1 through 9, then we set that grid position to that number, and then we call solve Sudoku again. If this new grid isn't false, then we return it. Otherwise, we backtrack. And that's it. That's all there is to that. It's really pretty simple. There are a lot of ways you could really, really mess with this if you wanted it to take a very, very long time, for instance. And I invite you to break it in the forms. Just to check real quick, let's check that my solution actually works. And this is for all of the inputs that we gave as example test cases. You can see that it does verify that the first two, the ill-formed and invalid ones, didn't work. And then for the valid one and easy, we didn't do hard simply because it would take this algorithm a little bit longer to do that. And I didn't want to wait. So then it shows that the valid and full already solved board is the exact same. And the easy board, it's filled out with a valid Sudoku board solution. So okay, see, I hope you enjoyed that, and I hope you enjoyed looking at everyone else's code and seeing how everyone thought about the problem and how you might think about testing the problem itself. So I hope you had a lot of fun with that. See you in the next unit.